In this next example, we're going to look at another question involving trigonometry. However, this is quite a tricky one because it doesn't actually signify anything about trigonometry. The question asks you to calculate the area of a rectangle. So let's have a look at it here. It says calculate the area of the rectangle. We've got a rectangle here, we've got 58 degrees in it and 15 centimetres on the bottom. It says here, do not use a scale drawing. Now what that means is, it doesn't mean you can't draw the triangle out and label the sides and things like that. It means you can't do an accurate drawing of it to scale. For example, drawing 15 centimetres along the way and getting a protractor and drawing 58 degrees, drawing it in and then measuring up and down. You've not to do that. You have to use a different technique. In this case, they're looking really for you to use trigonometry. Now the idea behind this question is for you to understand that to calculate the area of a rectangle, you need to do length times breadth. So we have the 15 here, but we don't know what the length is here, up and down the way. So that's kind of an unknown, if you like. Now what you need to look at, you think, well, is there any way I can calculate this? Quite a lot of times in harder mathematical questions, there's two steps to the final answer, or maybe more. The first step is to see that you need length times breadth, and then to think, okay, well, can I use another technique to work out the length of this triangle? So if you called that x, for example, we would have 15x and 58 degrees here, and you can see there's a right angle triangle there. So the right angle triangle is the one we're going to use trigonometry on to work out this length here. So as always, draw your right angle triangle out and label it. This is your opposite side, your hypotenuse is here, and this is your adjacent. So if we go over here, this is what it would look like. I've put an x here next to the opposite, hypotenuse, adjacent. So I need to work out what ratio to use. Again, we're not told. So the way to do that is to look at what sides you've been given and what sides you're trying to calculate. So straight away I'm looking at the 15 and I know we've been given the adjacent side. So I'm going to tick the A's up here. Remember to write SOHCAHTOA out. Okay, the other thing that I'm doing here, I'm trying to find out the opposite side. There's no information next to hypotenuse, I'm not trying to find it, I've not been given it, so I ignore the H's. So I'm trying to work out the opposite side, so I'm going to tick the O's. So from this up here, I can see that it's the tan ratio I'm going to use. So tan of the angle, in this case 58, is equal to opposite over adjacent. So tan 58 is equal to the opposite side is x and the adjacent side is 15. So to get x, you do 15 multiplied by tan 58 or tan 58 times 15. Make sure you put your 58 in brackets. I haven't done so here. I'll just put the bad brackets on there. So tan 58 times 15. And out pops your answer of 24 centimetres. So we know now that the height or the length here is 24 centimetres. We can go back to the first step to calculate the area. Area is equal to length times breadth. And we know that we've got 15 now and 24. So 15 times 24 is 360 centimetres squared. It's quite a complicated question in that you need to know the area of a rectangle. And then you needed to go back and use trigonometry to work out the length of the rectangle and also to spot the triangle and draw it out.